to what we start now.
So good afternoon, directors of the senior management of O+. I am Yong Wei-Jin, the business development executive, and today I'll be presenting to you the O+ Business Expansion Plan 2019. So why should O+ expand, you may ask? In 2017, O+ actually hit a sales high of 10,000 units and a profit margin of 60%, and this year, it is still continuing to increase. In order for our business to even grow larger than what it is now, we have to expand into foreign countries, which are much larger than the Singapore market. Without further ado, let me tell you the agenda of today's presentation. So firstly, I'll be sharing with you the location of expansion. Secondly, the target market group in Malaysia. Thirdly, the marketing strategies that we'll be using. Fourth, the unique selling point of O+ entering Malaysia. Fifth, the operations of store. Sixth, the startup budget. And lastly, I'll end up with conclusion and Q&A. So the chosen location for expansion is Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. So KL has been chosen because it is the capital of Malaysia and is also named the business and tourist hub of Malaysia. So why Malaysia chosen, you may ask? My team and I has actually researched on various business environment factors of Malaysia, which has led us come to the final decision of choosing Malaysia. Firstly, population size of Malaysia. Malaysia has a sizable population of 22 million, in which 1/3 lives in urban areas. So this is actually a much larger market as compared to Singapore. Thus, if Singapore is able to enter Malaysia, we'll be able to significantly increase our sales number as well as profitability. Next, currency exchange rate. So due to the lower exchange rate of ringgit compared to Singapore dollars, it will allow costs, operating costs and labor costs to be reduced significantly, which will help O+ increase profitability ultimately, which is the aim of our business. Thirdly, culture. Similarity with Singapore's culture, such as language, tastes and preferences, will help communication and marketing be much easier with the locals, and thus ensure a much easier entry into the market, into Malaysia. So lastly, competitors. As there are not many major eyewear competitor brands in Malaysia yet, O+ must act quickly and expand into Malaysia to ensure that we gain first mover advantage before our competitors do so. If we lag behind our competitors and do not expand quickly, our competitors will establish strong market presence before us, and it will be very difficult for O+ to actually enter into the Malaysia market in the future. So after covering the country analysis, who will be our target market group in Malaysia? So as O+ is a trendy and fashionable eyewear brand, our customers, our target market group will be consumers aged 25 to 40 years old who are young and trendy. This is because we want our customers to choose O+ as their first choice for fashionable as well as trendy and affordable eyewear brand. With our target market group identified, what marketing strategies will we use to enter into Malaysia? In order for us to create a trendy and fashionable image, we will be using online marketing and celebrity endorsement, which will be the two main marketing strategies that we will be using when entering into Malaysia. Firstly, for online marketing, we will be using social media marketing as well as online advertising. So as you know, Malaysia has over 68.1% internet penetration, which means that by using social media as well as online advertisement, we'll be able to gain market awareness quickly and enter the market through the use of internet. Next strategy that we're using is celebrity endorsement. So CEO of Swiss Relic Sally actually says that celebrity endorsement helped them sell for 1.7 billion in sales. Can you imagine if O+ reached such a sales number? Of course, we will be able to do so if we use celebrity endorsement. So to tackle the Malaysian market, we'll be endorsing Amber Chia, a popular and famous supermodel, celebrity and fashion icon in Malaysia. So the reason for choosing Amber Chia is because She's very fashionable and trendy, which is what our O Plus is trying to create our brand image. So by doing so, she'll be able to attract more customers, show that we are actually affordable yet trendy. Yeah. Next, with all the marketing strategies in place, what will be exactly marketing to our customers? So we'll be marketing our unique selling point to our customers in Malaysia. So the first, we have two unique selling points. The first is our high index aspirate lenses, which comes with UV protection as well as dust resistant coating. So this unique selling point actually allows our customer to prevent damages caused to the eyes from UV rays, as well as constantly keep their lenses clear from dust so that they will always come back and purchase our products. Next, high customer service quality. As O Plus is well known for our high customer service quality, we want to make sure that the Malaysia customers will feel that way as well. This is to make sure that our customers actually feel comfortable and have a sense of belonging when they enter our store and visit our store. This is so to increase customer loyalty and broaden our customer base in Malaysia. So now I'll be showing you some of the positive reviews on products and services that customers have shown on O Plus. So for, as you can see, many customers actually praise us on our high quality of workmanship as well as high quality service such as attentive and helpful. So we want to make sure that this will also be brought into Malaysia so that we'll be able to attack the market better. Now I'll be moving on to the most crucial part of the business expansion, which is the operation segment. So firstly, I'll be covering store location and store design. For store location, it will be at Pavilion Kuala Lumpur Shopping Mall. This location has been chosen because it is one of the most vibrant and crowded shopping malls in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. So as for rental costs, it will be average estimated at around RM45,000 per month, which is considerably cheaper than retail rental rates in Singapore, which is also one of the major reasons why we chose to enter into Malaysia. Next, for store design, O Plus will aim to have a simple and minimalistic design, as we want our customers to feel at home and comfortable when they visit our store, so that they will always choose to come back and patronize our store after their visits. Next, for O Plus to actually function efficiently and smoothly, human resource is actually very important. So as you can see, this will be the employment structure of the O Plus store in Malaysia. So in total, O Plus will actually be hiring 9 employees for our initial entry into Malaysia. So at the top, we'll have a store manager who is the expatriate sent in from Singapore. Second, we'll have an assistant manager, a head of retail crew, 2 full-time retail crew, as well as 4 part-time retail crews. So the reason why we chose the store manager to be an expatriate from Singapore is because we want someone who understands the operations inside out of O Plus, as well as because we want the store manager, the expatriate, to actually train the local assistant manager, which will eventually take over the store management in Malaysia. So as for recruitment, we'll be recruiting locals which have through interviews to make sure that they actually have a cheerful and approachable personality. As O Plus emphasize greatly on high customer service, we want all our employees to actually be of high standards of customer service. So we want them to actually be cheerful, approachable, so that customers will always choose to come back to O Plus. Next, I'll move on to employment costs. So as you can see, my team and I has actually researched on the industrial average in Malaysia. So as you can see, for store manager, the industrial average in Singapore is $4,370 per month. But because we will be sending the store manager into Malaysia, we want to mark up his salary as to compensate him for the accommodation costs as well as living costs in Malaysia. So for assistant manager, head of retail staff, full-time retail staff, and part-time retail staff, we have paid them slightly below or at industrial average because we want to save costs, but yet not underpay our staffs. Next, training and development. Firstly, we'll be providing training in product knowledge as well as customer service training. As O Plus, as I've said before, O Plus emphasizes greatly on high customer service. By having training in these two components, our employees will actually understand the product and the customer's needs very well and thus be able to serve the customers at its best. Now I'll move on to the final segment of the presentation, which is the startup budget. So this will be the estimated startup budget, which will consist of 3 months operating costs, which includes rental and wages, marketing expenses, which includes our marketing campaigns, our celebrity endorsements and such, rental deposits, which is 3 months of the rental rate, renovation costs, as well as pre-opening inventory. So in order to save costs, we have actually sourced for the cheapest renovation contractor quotation in Malaysia and also move our production from Singapore into Malaysia, in as operating cost is much cheaper in Malaysia. Thus, this will help us increase profitability. So with that, I've come to the end of my presentation and I'll now be concluding what I've covered today. So firstly, for location of expansion, it will be Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Our target market group will be customers aged 25 to 40 years old, which are young and trendy. Marketing strategies that we'll be using will be online marketing and celebrity endorsement, which will be Amber Chia. Our unique selling point will be our high index as freelancers, as well as high customer service. Our store will be located at Pavilion Kuala Lumpur Shopping Mall, with a simple and minimalistic design. For HR, we'll be hiring 9 employees in total for initial entry. And our estimated startup budget will be 598,000 ringgit for our initial expansion. Yeah. So with that, I end my presentation and now we'll move on to Q&A. Yeah, thank you.
Interesting. Your budget for the salary and wages, right?
Yeah.
Which include for the expatriate, right?
Yeah.
Do you factor in things like its accommodation costs and things like that? Have you taken that?
Yeah, because actually the industrial average for a store manager in Malaysia is actually only about 3,500 ringgit. So actually, based on the conversion rate, actually by paying our store manager 5,000 Singapore dollar per month, if you convert it into ringgit, it's actually three or four times more than the average income than a store manager in Malaysia. So we believe that this high increase in salary will actually be able to cover the accommodation costs, living costs, and for the store manager to actually adapt to the new environment that he or she will be in. Yeah.
What is your future plan after this one store? How would you want to grow it further, assuming your success?
Yeah, so I was actually waiting for someone to ask that because actually we have already have future expansion plans in place after Malaysia. So basically, O Plus will be adopting a franchising model, as we believe that the structure of our business is actually very organized and very simple, which is very suited for the franchise business model. So we will tackle other places in Malaysia such as JB and other states with our franchising model and hope to dominate the Malaysian market and move on to other regional markets such as Thailand and maybe Vietnam and Myanmar. Yeah.
Any other questions? Thank you.
No further questions. Okay. So with that, I end my presentation. Yeah. Thank you.